1000s of psycho libs have horrifying protest planned for Trump's anniversary. Here's what you must know. It has almost been a year since Donald Trump was elected as president, and liberals are still throwing one heck of temper tantrum. Instead of these open-minded individuals accepting President Trump and his agenda like they accept a 40-year-old man in the ladies' bathroom, they are still kicking and screaming. That has been evident in the way that the left has been doing all they can to destroy Trump and his plans to make America great again. If they are not accusing Trump and his team of racism and bigotry, they are spreading lies about Russian collusion and pushing for his impeachment. So, as the one-year anniversary of Trump winning the election quickly approaches, these deranged liberals are planning a protest that will prove just how insane they really are. There is no doubt in anyone's mind that liberals make very little sense in their thinking. For instance, those on the left will scream to protect the innocent lives of animals, but won't think twice about promoting abortion. They also will yell that Trump is unconstitutional when he writes an executive order, but enthusiastically cheered when Barack Obama wrote them in his 8 years. At any rate, the left is planning on protesting the legitimately elected President Trump on November 9th in cities across America. No, they won't be burning cars or destroying public property, but what they do plan to do will make you scratch your head in amazement. These politically correct individuals will stand together and scream helplessly at the sky to express their frustration over the state of our country. Reaction GIFs, find and share on Jiffy. Here is more from people. Ever felt so angry you could just scream over the 2016 election outcome? Here's your chance. On November 8, thousands of concerned Americans will commemorate the one-year anniversary of President Donald Trump's election by screaming helplessly into the sky. Organizers in at least 9 cities across the country, including Los Angeles, Miami, Austin, New York City and Chicago, are using Facebook to plan demonstrations titled Scream Helplessly at the Sky on the anniversary of the election. At least 2,200 people are planning to attend the New York event in Washington Square Park, while 15,000 more have expressed interest in going. Join us gucks and snowflakes, safe spacers and libtards, as we enjoy a collective cathartic yell into the heavens about our current political establishment, reads the tongue-in-cheek event description. The multi-city event originated in Boston, where more than 4,000 planned to head to Boston Common for the cathartic scream session. But Vice reported that the event was shut down on Tuesday due to what local activist and organizer Johanna Schulman called circumstances beyond our control. Schulman previously told Newsweek that she was inspired to organize the event because this administration has attacked everything about what it means to be American. Who wouldn't feel helpless every day? Coming together reminds us that we are not alone, that we are part of an enormous community of activists who are motivated and angry, whose actions can make a difference, she added. While the event invites people to scream helplessly, Schulman says the larger goal is to convert that sense of helplessness into resistance, into action, and maybe even into optimism. Although it is important to acknowledge the tragedy that befell our country on November 9, we cannot let it defeat us, she said. While you gather your thoughts after reading such lunacy or scream, we will break this down, okay? These liberals are claiming that Trump is attacking everything that is American but never give any examples. Are they claiming that Trump is dismantling America by protecting our borders? Well, that would make little no sense since the majority of countries around the world protect their borders to keep riffraff out. Okay, so are they insinuating that Trump is ruining America by giving the power back to the people and allowing them to decide what is best for their families? Or, are they angry that Trump is finally putting an end to all the Obama policies that have been running our country into the ground for close to a decade? There is no real reason for these leftists to be this hateful towards President Trump since he has done nothing to harm anyone at all. In fact, the only reason they are upset with Trump is that he was the man to beat Hillary Clinton, which was not supposed to happen. It is unfortunate to witness thousands of grown adults gathering together to scream over the President of the United States. If they really cared about the country, they would join together to make America great again, and push these childish antics aside.